Thank you, Mr. Chairman. General Milley, I want to come back to you. We discussed that you have had conversations with Woodward, Costa, Leonig, Rucker, and Bender on their books, correct?
Not Costa.
You did not on Costa. Well,
not Costa.
Social media.
Woodward, yes, and others.
We'll leave that as a point of discussion. Okay, in any of these conversations, did you discuss private meetings with the president or White House officials?
White House officials, perhaps. President, I don't think so.
So you never discussed any of your conversations with President Trump?
With President Trump.
With any of these officers?
Not a private conversation.
Okay. Did you portray the commander-in-chief in a negative light or make comments that were critical of the commander-in-chief to any of these authors with which you had conversations?
Not my comments or my observations, no.
You
others
did not.
That were relayed to me from others,
okay.
Perhaps.
Well, I'm looking forward to your book report on
great.
This. Would you see these conversations as an abuse of executive privilege?
I would not, no.
You would not. Okay. Let me ask you this. What is your standard for determining when to leak private conversations with a president?
I don't leak private conversations with the president.
You did not. So you had these conversations with the authors, but you don't see that as leaking information to which they were not entitled to know. See, this is the problem that we have. See, as a member of this committee and as someone who represents a lot of our men and women in uniform that are there, as we've referenced today, I've really got an issue with the fact that you will talk to authors, but then you all come in here and you say, well, we can't tell you what we told the president. And then I have to drag it out of you that the written documents, which under Article 2, you're supposed to give those to us. You can't go hide behind somebody's skirts on this. And you don't want to give those to us. So you've repeatedly told this committee that you will not reveal your private conversations with President Biden. But then you've leaked this information from your meetings with President Trump. So it is important to us that you truthfully respond to us on this.
Absolutely.
And I think what you did with making time to talk to these authors, burnishing your image, kind of, you know, building that bluster, but then not putting the focus on Afghanistan and what was happening there. General Milley, that is really disappointing to me. I know it's disappointing to people that have served with you or under you, under your command. And it does not serve our nation well. You talked a little bit earlier about the damage, and you said damage was the right word to use when assessing what has happened in Afghanistan, when you look at America's credibility. So how do you look the men and women in the eye that have served under your command? How do you look young men in the eye that are coming to our military academy days and who want to serve and say, you can depend on me, I've got your back? Because you know what? I think a lot of these families right now, they don't feel like you have your back. The special ops guys I met with Friday in my office in Nashville that are taking their time, their money, and risking their lives to do a job that the three of you could not do. Maybe we're going to remember you three as the three that broke the military. I don't know. But this is causing just a lot of anger from people who have trusted the military. They have felt like the military was one of the most trustworthy institutions. But in order to get a name in a book, in order to not be drawn into a political fight, what you have managed to do is to politicize the U.S. military, to downgrade our reputation with our allies. Nobody has resigned. Nobody has submitted their resignation. And we've got thousands of people watching this hearing today that are looking at you all and saying, I can't believe they're sitting there and not answering the questions and are trying to punt. I yield back.